Hello everyone, welcome to this video on boundary layer clustering. In GridPro, boundary layer can be done as a part of grid generation or as a post process. In this video, we will be focusing on the post processing of the initial grid. The case considered here is a simple pipe with grid for both fluid and solid domain. The goal is to refine the boundary layer for the fluid domain alone, which is shown by the arrow displayed. To apply boundary layer clustering, we use the clustering option in the edit section of the grid panel. The input grid file is chosen by selecting the grid name. This gives us option to have multiple grids in the UI and apply the boundary layer clustering. The grid is auto-selected if only one grid is loaded in the UI. The input parameters for defining the boundary layer can be set in two ways. One, using surface IDs, two, using a text file. We'll be using the surface ID option in this video. Click on the CLU push button to input the parameters. It opens up the parameters window as shown here. All the surface IDs as well as the labels in the grid are red when the window pops up. Enable the desired surface ID to input the parameters. The surface ID 4 represents the interface grid sheet between the solid and fluid domain. The surface ID can be found from the show or hide slices section. Since the fluid boundary is an internal sheet in the grid, the direction for clustering has to be chosen. In this case, the positive side for the interface grid sheet is selected. For now, the direction selection is a trial and error method. The first cell spacing is chosen to be 0.001 and the rest of the inputs are set to default values. Click on Set Parameters to input these entered values. Then click on the Apply button in the dialog box to execute the clustering operation. The output grid is loaded into the UI once the clustering is executed. The clustering automatically calculates the number of layers of the wall space to ensure a smooth transition and growth. To summarize the video, boundary layer clustering in GridPro can be done as a part of grid generation and as a post process with the effective control of spacing, growth, and number of cells. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel to get more updates.